إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر أمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد يا عباد الله. And continuing with going over the شروط, the conditions for the second part of the Shahada. If we truly want to benefit from the second part of the Shahada, وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ, and I testify by witness that Muhammad is his slave and is his messenger, is the slave of Allah and the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then fifthly, شرط الخامس محبته أشد من محبة النفس والمال والوالد والولد والناس أجمعين, is that we have to love the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than an individual loves themselves, and more than they love money, and more than they love their parents, and more than they love their children, and more than they love all of mankind. We have to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than we love all of mankind, all of creation. Meaning that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as relates to the created things, then we have more love for him than anything else that is created. From the created things, from Allah's creatures, we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the most. Because he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the most fearing of Allah's creatures. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the most diligent in his obedience of Allah's creatures. And this is why he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the best of Allah's creatures. So therefore we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than we love any other of Allah's creatures. Naam. An Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qal Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam la yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min walidihi wa waladihi wan nas ajma'in. Hadith muttafaqun alayh. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in this hadith that has been narrated on the authority of Anas bin Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that hadith that is collected in al-Bukhari and Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, none of you truly believes until I become more beloved unto him than his parents, his children, and all of mankind. This hadith here is a straight and clear proof and evidence that we have to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than we love all of mankind. And this is because in the deen of al-Islam, our love is conditional. Naam. In the deen of al-Islam, our love is conditional. We love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only one who we love for him and him alone is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bidhati, because it is Allah azza wa jal. We love Allah azza wa jal alone, because we love Allah azza wa jal. The love that we have for everything else is thus subsequently connected to our love for Allah azza wa jal. So when an individual is obedient unto Allah azza wa jal, then you find we love that individual. The more obedient they are, the more love we have for that individual. And vice versa. Naam. And this is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he is the most beloved to us from Allah's creatures. Because we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam for the sake of Allah azza wa jal. And because he is obedient unto Allah azza wa jal. Because he is from the most observant of Allah's creatures to Allah's commands, then we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam more than we love the other creatures. Naam. على كل حال. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه فيما رواه البخاري في الصحيح. And on the authority of Abu Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه, and that which is collected by al-Bukhari inside of his collection of authentic hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, والذي نفسي بيده, and by the one whom my soul is in his hands, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, and I swear by the one whom my soul is in his hands, that none of you will truly believe until I become more beloved to him than his parents and his children. وعن عبد الله بن هشام وعن عبد الله بن هشام رضي الله تعالى عنه قال كنا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو آخذ بيد عمر وهو آخذ بيد عمر ابن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه فقال له عمر يا رسول الله لأنت أحب إلي من كل شيء لا من نفسي قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا والذي نفسي بيده حتى أكون أحب إليك من نفسك فقال له عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه فإنه الآن والله لأنت أحب إلي من نفسي فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم الآن يا عمر. On the authority of Abdullah bin Hisham radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, we were with the Prophet. We were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was holding the hand of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. So Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, we said unto him, O Messenger of Allah, verily I love you more than I love everything else except for myself. فَقَالَ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, no, negating, no, by the one whom my soul is in his hand, indicating to Umar that what? That his statement was incorrect. This is not correct. He said, no, but by the one whom my soul is in his hands, not until I become more beloved to you than even yourself. فَقَالَ لَهُ عُمَرُ. So Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said unto him, then since this is the case, then now, and I swear by Allah, you are more beloved to me than even myself. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, now, O Umar, now, na'am, meaning now you got it. Now you're correct. It is incumbent that we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not illustrated by celebrating his birthday. Loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not illustrated by acting contradictory to his sunnah, by acting in contradiction to his sunnah. Loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not striving to be different than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But rather loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will necessitate that an individual, he imitates and he follows the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the best and the finest of examples. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُصْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. That verily you have for you in the Messenger of Allah the most excellent of examples. So we have to imitate the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and if we truly love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we should want to imitate him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, what enters into loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not just that we say and we make a mere articulation with our tongues that we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is not that which is restricted to just a mere claim, but rather loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it becomes truly manifest in us following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and obeying the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As the poet he said, لَوْ كَانَ حُبُّكَ صَادِقًا لَأَطَعْتَهُ إِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ. That verily, if your love for him was true, then you would have obeyed him. If your love for him was true, then you would have obeyed him. Because verily, the one who truly loves someone, he is unto that individual one who is obedient unto him. He is unto that individual one who is obedient. So if we truly love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we have to be obedient unto the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is being obedient unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it is Allah azza wa jalla says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. Allah ta'ala, he is the one who says, O you who believe, obey Allah and obey the Messenger. O you who believe, obey Allah and obey the Messenger. So if we truly love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we have to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have to obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if our love for him is true, right and exact. هذا أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين فاستغفروا فإنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد يا عباد الله. We have to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam with the true and Islamic love. We have to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam because he's the most obedient of the creatures of Allah azza wa jalla. So therefore we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam more than we love all of the other creatures of Allah azza wa jalla. And in loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then we have to obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we have to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which brings us to our next condition. And that is sharq as-sadis, the sixth condition, taqdeemu qawlu ala qawli kulli ahad. We have to put the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam before the statement of everyone. Kainan man kan, whoever who they are. But we put the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before the statement of everyone, min al-nas, from the human beings. Everyone from the human beings. Kainan man kan, whoever that person may be. Wa amal bi sunnatihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we have to act in accordance to his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a very important point. If we truly want to benefit from the second part of the Shahada, وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, and I testify by witness that Muhammad is his slave and messenger, I testify by witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, then we have to put the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before the statement of everyone else from mankind, because Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, هو الرسول الله, he is the messenger of Allah. So therefore, I don't care who has attained what they have attained from greatness, who has attained whatever they have attained from scholarship. We're not going to put their statement before the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because at the end of the day, at the end of the affair, the Messenger of Allah, that is the Messenger of Allah, and this other individual, he is not the Messenger of Allah. So it doesn't make sense that we will put the statement of someone who is not Allah's Messenger before the statement of Allah's Messenger, especially when we're talking about Allah's deen. We're speaking about Allah's religion. When we're speaking about the deen of al-Islam. Once it has been established that the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was to do X, Y, and Z, then that's what we do. We don't care who else comes and say, but Imam so-and-so said, but in Madhab Fulani it says this, Al-Allama says such and such. No, we don't care about what any Madhab says. We don't care about what any Allama says. We don't care about what any Shaykh says. We don't care about what any whoever says. If it is in contradiction to what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, then we will respectfully decline whatever comes from these individuals, no matter how great they may be, and we stick to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And because any shaykh, any alim, any alim who that is worth his weight in salt, except that he will tell you that if what I say contradicts the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then take my statement and throw it away and stick to what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. No one who has any value, who is worth their weight in salt, except that they will tell you this. Anyone that will tell you, take what I say even over that which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, take what I say even over that which is found inside of the authentic hadith, then this is an individual, bila shak wa bila rayb, an individual who is evil. This is an individual who you should never give your ear unto him. This is an individual who you should run away from him. This is an individual who he will call you to nothing good. This is an individual who the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has described to them to us in the hadith of Hudhayfa, those du'at who are on the gates and the doors of the hell, and they invite people to it. This is that individual telling you to discard the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to stick to what they are saying? No way. We don't put any human being statement before the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ka'inan man kan, whoever they may be. And every imam from the imams of the four madhabs, Abu Hanifa, wa Imam Malik, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, and Imam Ahmed, all of them have statements which are similar to, if you find what I say contradicting the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then take what I say and get rid of it. Throw it away. Throw it to the wall. Throw it under your foot. Disregard it. They all make statements similar unto this. All four of them. So anyone who follows any one of these madhahib, from the madhahib of Ahl Sunnah, that is incumbent for you to know that it is not only upon you to follow that madhab when it coincides with the proofs and the evidences as relates to Islamic jurisprudence, but also that you have the aqidah, that you have the belief, you have the creed of the imams of that madhab, because each one of those imams, each one of them was Sunni Salafi. Each one of them. There was not a single one from amongst those four who was from Ahl al-Bid'ah. And there's not a single one from amongst those four except that they're human beings. Sometimes they were right, sometimes they were wrong, sometimes they were correct, sometimes they were mistaken. Because that's how human beings are. So whenever you find anything from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that's what you cling on to. And you discard the statement of anyone else. Ka'inan man kan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commands us with this inside of the Quran. Allah Ta'ala, he says, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوا وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the messenger gives you, take it. Whatever he prevents you from, stay away from it. That's clear. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدِي اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Allah Ta'ala, he says, O you who believe, do not precede yourselves in front of the statement of Allah and his messenger and fear Allah. Do not precede yourselves with rulings, making rulings and judgment before you first know the ruling and judgment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the ruling and judgment from the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do not put yourselves first. Do not proceed by saying things about the deen of al-Islam and you don't know what you're talking about. Do not put yourself forward and you proceed saying things about the deen of al-Islam and it contradicts the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here in this ayah from Surah Al-Hujurat, the first ayah, Allah ta'ala commands us not to do this. And then Allah ta'ala says, وَاتَّقُوا and fear Allah and have fear for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is incumbent that we fear Allah Azza wa Jal, and we don't put anyone's statement before the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we're not going to put anyone's statement, no matter how great they are, from the human beings in front of the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those who truly want to benefit from the second part of the Shahada, this must be your way. There is no other alternative. وَشَرُقَ السَّابِعِ, and the seventh and final condition from the conditions of the second part of the Shahada is that we have to ta'zeemuhu wa tawqeeruhu wa ihtiramuhu wa ijlaluhu, is that we have to honor, hold in high esteem, respect, and have admiration for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it is incumbent for us to know, because everyone will say, oh yes, I do that. I honor and respect and hold in high esteem the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is important to know that i'zamuhu wa ta'zeemuhu wa tawqeeruhu wa ihtiramuhu wa ijlaluhu huwa i'zam ma ja'a bihi min indillah wa huwa kitab wa sunnah al-mutahhara wa la yakunu dhalika illa بالعمل بهما ومحبتهما أعظم من محبة الناس والنفس. Is that in honoring, in holding in high esteem, having admiration and having a respect for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that means that we have a respect and we honor that in which he has come with from Allah Azza wa Jal. And that is the book, and that is the sunnah, the pure sunnah. And this is not accomplished unless we implement and we practice and we follow the book and the sunnah. That we practice and we follow the Quran and the sunnah of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that we love him more than we love the human beings and ourselves. That we love the Kitab and the Sunnah more than we love ourselves. So although there may be times because our soul caused the evil that we want to do something that's wrong, contradiction to the book and the Sunnah, because we have more love for Allah, more love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam than we have for ourselves, because we love the book and the Sunnah more than we love even ourselves, then we what? Then we're going to put the evil, what we want, to the back burner, and we're going to comply with the rule from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how we show respect to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you take as an example your own child, if your own child was constantly disrespecting you, was constantly being and acting contrary to you, then what will you say unto him? Huh? Even though he claims he loves you, even though he claims he honors you, even though, due to his constant disobedience to you and being contrary to you, will say, young man, you don't respect me. I tell you to do things and you do the opposite. I try to advise you on certain things and you do the opposite. You don't respect me. Because if you respect what I said, then you would take it into account and you would what? You would fall in line. Sahwulillah. But for Allah is the greatest example. But for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, does not this example hold true? That we contradict him at every step and then we say, but we honor him? And when I mean every step, I mean figuratively, not literally every step, because we spoke about that in the last khutbah. But I mean we contradict him here, we contradict him there, we don't obey him here, we don't obey him there. Then we say, oh no, but we got a lot of respect for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have to have respect for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira. That verily we have sent you as a witness, we have sent you as a giver of glad tidings, and we have sent you as a warner. لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُعَزِّرُوهُ وَتُوَقِّرُوهُ. and that so that they may believe in Allah and believe in His Messenger, and so that they may honor you and assist you, so that they may assist you and honor you. Assist and honor him. Who? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Are we assisting and honoring the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Are we striving to push and to call to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Are we striving to spread the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to all of mankind? Even before that, are we implementing and striving to assist the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as relates to our own lives and our own selves? Or are we doing opposite of that? Because we're supposed to assist the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We're supposed to assist him, and we're supposed to what? We're supposed to have honor and respect for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that is shown by following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, obeying the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we truly want to benefit from the second part of the Shahada, then all seven of these conditions have to be implemented. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes us of those who implement these conditions with a beautiful implementation. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يوفقني وإياكم لما يحبه ويرضى وأن يجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنا وأن يجعلنا مباركا حيثما كنا وأن يجعلنا ممن إذا أعطي شكر وابتلي صبر وإذا أذنب استغفر فإن هؤلاء ثلاثة عنوان السعادة هذا يا عباد فأقيموا الصلاة.